This is Carla. As you've heard, Periscope will be shutting down March 31st, 2021. And I'm very, very sad about it because Periscope was the first live stream platform that I was on since 2015. And so it was 6 years old, March 26th. So as a eulogy, I wanted to talk about the five things that I'll miss about Periscope. So number one, the live streaming ecosystem. Everyone knew that Periscope was its own app, so its ecosystem was quite different than Twitter. And that's also what you liked about it. You liked that you can have your own ecosystem. Just like right now, Instagram TV has its own app and it's separate from Instagram. And that's because it's vertical, well, originally vertical, pre-recorded standalone video. So it's a different ecosystem than IG. And I'm very disappointed that, Twitter is getting rid of it because number one, it had its own ecosystem. Number two, I'll miss it because of Perry Girls. So I did, I think, 2 to 3 stints of Perry Girls, which was going live, was one of the largest communities at the time on Periscope. You would go live. If you were in the Heart Tribes, you would go live every single day for 6 days a week, Mondays through Saturday. You had Sundays off. And you would do it every 2 weeks and you would sign up and keep signing up. And that really taught me a lot about being diligent, going and just putting out content and showing up for the community is something that I needed when I did my own branding, just showing up. And that also led to number three, which was Projectize. I started Projectize, my project management show, January 8th, 2019, right on Periscope. And I went live Mondays through Fridays. I have over 300 shows. Yes, I expanded Projectize to YouTube Live and Instagram Live, but it originally started on Projectize and Periscope because on Periscope and on Twitter, there was a very big lack of project management content. Even before the pandemic, project management was huge. It was one of the biggest careers. Getting the project management professional, that was a ticket to like a lot of money. And people were calling themselves project managers, but you didn't have certified project managers doing, live streams. So I just took it upon myself to create the show. And over 2 years later, we have over 300 shows. A lot of them are now on YouTube and Instagram Live. Some of them I saved to IGTV. But that's, starting Projectize on Periscope provided me an opportunity to do my own show, which was very important. And that show actually helped me land my teaching opportunities because people would talk about how they saw my videos. And my moving from Periscope and adding and multi-streaming on YouTube Live really, really helped. But if I didn't start on Periscope, it wouldn't have been a YouTube Live or an Instagram Live. So that's number three. Number four is learning from others. Unlike Facebook, who you actually have to know or connect with to get the live streams, I know they have this watch tab. With Periscope, all you had to know was the hashtag. And they had the main things where everyone was streaming. So there was more transparency and it was easier just to pop in other people's broadcasts based on what the title was. And that's something I will really, really miss too. Because now you have to know the person. Even with Instagram Live, you actually have to know the person. The only people you know who go live are the people you follow. And with Periscope, that was completely different. You didn't have to follow the person. You can just bump into their broadcast. And then number five, without miss, is my community on Periscope. I have 400 followers, and I don't know if when they're rolling it into Twitter, what would happen with them. But I truly like my followers, them, commenting, sharing, referencing me. It matters a lot because it was its own ecosystem, like in the beginning, like I said, in number one. So yes, I'll miss Periscope. Periscope helped me a lot get to where I am at. It provided me with an opportunity to learn live stream, master it way before it became mainstream. It helped me adequately prepare for video marketing in 2015 when you're like 5 years off. Like right now in 2021, most things are video, but in 2015, that wasn't the case. And what Periscope also did was help me go beyond, you know, just see around corners and how to prepare and get my personal branding together. So that's a bonus. But I'll miss Periscope. But just remember, for all things Carlr Jenkins, check me out at carlrjenkins.com.